はい、この時間はエイピアグループ代表取締役 CEO の千半優さんにお話を伺います。千半さん、どうぞよろしくお願いいたします。
Thank you, Watanabe-san, for having me. I'm very pleased to join the interview session today. Appia is AI software service company that use AI to empower business to make decisions more efficiently and more precisely. The company was founded in 2012 by a group of very passionate computer scientists and engineersas well as business executive that with expertise in AI data analytics and marketing. Our vision is making AI easy by making software intelligence. We envision every software will be powered by AI in the future, and we want to be the one of the key driver in this very important software revolution. We also have our very important mission, turning AI into ROI by making software intelligence.What we offer is particularly critical in the macro environments at this moment, and we continue innovating in these directions. Our technology brings predictable and visible return to our customers and on their digital marketing investment and lead to their business success. Yeah, thank you for having me again.
今御社の事業内容を伺いました。で、御社いろいろこう海外に展開されているということでありますので、まず海外展開の度合いですね、今どんな形で展開されているのかというところと、さらに御社の足元の業績内容について伺えればと思います。よろしくお願いします。
We start our business in Asia Pacific region and gradually expand to US and Europe with 17 offices globally. Our revenue base is very diversifiedAnd Northeast Asia will then be a solid foundation of our business. Contributing, this is a Q3 2022 result, contributing more than 60% of total revenue with more over 50% year-on-year growth rate. Greater China region continue to grow steadily with emerging opportunity, many diversified vertical opportunities. And US and EMEA is the fast growing region since we entered the market in Q3 2022.The revenue grew 7 times compared with the same period last year. And we expect our growth momentum will continue in the next few years as we continue exploring new regions with efficient go-to-market strategies. And our metric demonstrates strong scale, velocity, and stability as we continue to drive productivity and efficiency internally together with continuous new business opportunity development.In terms of scale, we grew our customer base by around 30% year-on-year, generating 18.2 billion yen annual recurring revenue, representing 55% year-on-year growth rate in Q3 2022. Such scalability is supported by over 620 employees as we continue our stable hiring pace, even under macro environment uncertainties. For velocity, the high level of growth for both our revenue and profitability, we have achieved 69% year-on-year growth of gross profit growth. And also back in Q3 2022, we also achieved profitable quarter as well. As for stability, and we have achieved more approximately 125% of NRR with only 0.62% of a monthly churn rate.And we also, Q3 2022, we also generate 7% of EBITDA margins. And overall, we are very positive about our revenue growth trajectory. As you can see, our revenue growth has been accelerating. Our EBITDA margin has been improving over time. And due to our outperformance, we have revised our guidance upward in 3 quarters in a row back in 2022.We revised our revenue forecast upward from 18.5 billion Japanese yen to 19.2 billion Japanese yen, representing 51% of growth and from previously 46% of growth. At the same time, we also further revised our EBITDA upward. And so now we have 1.2 billion Japanese yen's EBITDA, representing 6.3% of EBITDA margins.And with 3 quarters in a row revision, now our operating profit level is close to break-even level. And you can see that our operations demonstrate strong leverage. We announced our 2025 financial targets with more than 30% growth and with gross margin approximately 55 to 60% and 15 to 20% of operating margins.As you can see that every year we are approaching this goal. with each year sales and marketing, R&D and G&A ratio as approaching the goal that we want to reach in 2025. While our metrics and financial results have shown robust and continuous growth, our team continued working very hard to expand our business opportunity to bring the best shareholder value to all our shareholders. And we continue working hard toward our mission, turning AI into ROI. We help our customer grow, then we grow with them together.
経営者の視点からご覧になってですね、御社のここが強いんだっていうビジネスモデルの強み、そして今後の成長戦略についてお話を伺えればと思います。
Thank you so much for asking this question. I think the most unique is the aspect that Appio have very strong network effects from our business. From a product side, we have the flywheel effects that can really drive the network effects.One, the starting from we have very complementary products and very complementary products that actually collect data from various different sources from our customers' users. And when customers use more of our product, our AI can learn even better. When our AI learn better and it generates even more training data for our AI, and our AI learn even better, our customers use even more of our product. So it goes into the positive cycle.And then really enhance our net revenue retention of our customer. And this network effect driving a very strong growth from our customers. On the other hand, we also have very good business productivity because we continue to enhance our sales productivity and at the same time improve our gross margin with higher gross profit per customer. We are able to invest into further acquire even more customer profitably.And both network effects allow us to continue to grow our business. So basically, when we have more customers and we have more products, when we operate longer, and this network effect actually make the whole product service even much better. So this is a more user driving better business and more business driving even more data for us to learn. So this and more data for us to learn our product quality.Then actually improve with that. So this is really two network effects driving our growth and also product differentiations. And we also have a very robust business. Our solutions are return driven. Basically, we allow our customers to drive a predictable return. When customers spend in marketing, the best is that they know where their spending can really, whether their spending can really turn into very good return. And when they have a good return, they can further grow their business. And we use AI to bring this predictability and the visibility for our customers. So now they actually can use AI even before they start in marketing activity to predict about the future.And we also have very robust business because most of our customers are larger enterprises that contribute more than 90% of our revenue. And because of that, it's really helped us give us a very diversified while robust customer base and more higher business resilience toward uncertainty in macro environments. And we also have very good upsell and cross-sell product strategy. And because we have our Appio,provide full funnel solution from user acquisition, user retention, user transaction, and prediction of a future behavior. And such connection and such synergy between product allow us to upsell and cross-sell different product very easily. So imagining that our salespeople, when they go to customer, they have a full suite of a Swiss knife, almost like Swiss knife of different product that they can present to their to customers. Customer then is very easier for us to have good business result from every single business engagement with our customers. So all those three aspects allow us to have very robust business and also continue with a high growth rate.
最後にこの番組をご覧の株主投資家の皆さんにメッセージを一言お願いします。
Yeah, we sincerely express our gratitude toward our shareholders, customer, employees, and partner for their support, which enable Appio to successfully complete transfer to Prime in less than 2 years after original listing in Mothers. Appio is committed to become a strong and well-recognized listed company.And we always talk to all our employees and also internal stakeholders that the first 10 years of Appio has become a successful regional private company, but next 10 years, we want to be a successful global public listed company. And listing in a prime is an important milestone for the company. And following the segment transfer, we expect our investor to become more diversified and further enhance our corporate value. At the same time, our management team will also commit to continue to improve and also all every aspect of our operation and continue expanding our business and also have a corporate governance as an important aspect in all our operations. We thank you so much for having us, and we will continue driving further growth and turn AI into ROI.
この時間はエイピアグループ代表取締役 CEO の智範優さんにお話を伺いました。智範さん、どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you so much, and we will see you soon.